Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war and poverty. Oh, oh, oh. Wake up, all the teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say.
Well, welcome to Community Matters. We finally gonna bring some things to you up to the community that is really very well needed to be said for us to understand what is really, really all about. And Community Matters is what we're willing to do for the community and the people in the community. We have a lot of talk about fixing this charter, you know, and a lot of people understand that we have a consolidated government. Consolidated government is been there since, I know it, of 96. They said it was voted up in 93, but until 96, that's when they came out with consolidated government. I've been going through a lot of consolidated government meeting when they was at 1010 Lafayette Street. When they converted the old Sears building into consolidated government, this is where we came in at. And we came in, you know, with a lot of new rules and regulations, you know, the things that we needed, you know, to really make things happen for us. We had councilmen that was bullying us, doing certain things to make a difference in our communities, in the city, in the parish of Lafayette. You know, and I made a lot of meetings. And my friend Jeffrey Landry, Jeffrey Bunny Landry Jr., and I went to a lot of meetings. We used to kind of like try to keep the community up to par. We was going to consolidated government meetings to make sure our community, the community that we live in, the district that we live in, had something coming to make our district and our community look better. Well, lately, they come out with fixing the charter, you know. Fixing the charter. Man, oh man, that's a big joke. You know, it's something that I call gerrymandering. Segregating our community, segregating the district, taking from the district that the district been having. They want to reroute the district, move the lines in the district, and you know, at one time, when they first start talking about fixing the charter, well, they was gonna redistrict things and put it in a predominantly white conservative district. And it was Bruce Kant district, you know. And I'm going to be real, because this is Community Matters. This is what the community needs to know, you know. And I hope when this program is aired, you know, we listen and try to understand what is really going on. Well, when they decided to put it in Bruce Kant district, you know, Bruce Kant take a part of the district that he wanted to satisfy the council in what they was doing. Well, I guess after they made that public, you know, they figure, well, you know, this is a predominantly black district. Blacks is not gonna go for that. Well, let's do something about with District 4. We're going to bring District 4 because now is a predominantly black district and is a black that run that district. So we're going to take him and make him take this area or allow him to come in this area, and blacks gonna vote for it. That's not the way it should be. That's not the way it should be, you know? So now, you know, you got these people on the council because they was elected official, because they've been sitting on the seat X amount of years, but now they can't run again for office. So, oh, let's mess up this charter thing. You know, let's call it break the charter. And that's what they did. They broke it for them to gain a couple of more years in the seat that they're in, because they wanted to try to take, you know, term limit off of them being an elected official, a term limit. So now they're gonna take the term limit off, and when, you know, they come up with amendment not to amend that into fixing the charter, you know, the guy that was really wanted to run for re-election, they didn't stand with him. Everybody voted against him, you know, to take term limit or keep term limit into the charter, not take it away. And that's how it was going. So now, you know, here come this guy, he's gonna get this one on his program and that one on his program, and his man and his confidant, you know, lady that run the voters registration office, they gonna be all of this and all of that, you know. But the thing of it is, they're not standing with us. And then he gonna go and convince others fixing the charter would be the best thing. And then you got some accepting money to campaign to tell the black folk this is good for us. What in the world this is coming to, you know? And trust me, you know, it's going to be some that don't like what I'm saying, but I'm telling the truth, you know. Christianity and equal rights. Knowing the truth, will set you free. Telling the truth don't always free you. But I want you to know the truth so you could be free for when all this was big old pot of mud be sorted out, be hardened, and all the slices be equal, you will know the truth. Fixing the charter is breaking up what a former city councilman, Wilfred Pierre, had to fight and struggle to put together to get a district for us people of color. A people of color district, you know? Because it's not all black in the district, it's people of color, you know? And you're gonna go out of your way to disrupt that, to break that up, to take the people of color district away from them. To disrespect yourself, disrespect the people that look up to you. You don't know your civil rights. They tearing us up in our civil right. We in our 50th anniversary, going on the 51st anniversary of our civil right movement. And all of that is getting ready to be torn down because somebody say they got some education, they got some college education, they got some this, they got people that put them in office, you know. But they wasn't around for the civil right movement. They might have read about it, you know. We are people of color, you know. Is being jealous, is being hated, it being envious, hardened-hearted, go along to get along, you know. And don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to say, you know, I know it all. But I do know this much. I understand what's happening with the district that I live in, the district that they using or sending one of us to get all of us. Yes, you know, why do we hate one another where we live at or how we live in or what we have to live? Where I live at, I choose to live there. Where somebody else live at, I'm happy for them. I ain't got time to hate on them because they living with a driveway better than mine. They got a metal roof. I got a shingle roof. To me, that's non-involved. I'm trying to live in a community that we gonna be happy in when people come to visit us. They could look and say, wow, this is a nice place. I wouldn't mind living here. I know it haven't been like that. Little man, big man. The people voted you in office. It's the people. voted you in office. Well, not because you had an education, you know. The people voted you in office to look out for them, not to trash them, not to talk about them, but to make their life a little bit easier, a little bit better. Stop the madness. All black people is not forgiving people. But guess what? We do forgive. We do forgive the lowdown that happens to us. You know? We do forgive that. But why? Because of our upbringing, the way that we supposed to do things, you know? Fixing the charter is not one of them. You know, fixing the charter is not one of them. Be careful of the lies you hear that sound like the truth. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Friend of mine always said, why, you know? Be careful of the lies that sound like the truth. That ain't no good, you know? Knowing the truth will set you free. Look out for false teachings. Look out for false teachings. And there's a lot of that going on right now. Because people wants to be the boss, I could say it. They wants to be the speaker for us. The civil rights movement. Some of us never went through the civil rights movement. Okay? Some of us don't even know about the civil rights movement no more than what we read. You know? And all books don't tell the truth. You know? Always be careful of what you hear. Always. You know? Because everybody have a slick tongue. The devil have a slick tongue. Seriously. Watch how you think about godly people that think they're godly. That's a good one. Oh, they're gonna talk about God. They're gonna holler hallelujah, amen, praise the Lord, you know. But you got to distinguish which one coming to you with horns and which one coming to you as an angel. Because they'll do that. They'll do that. They'll bring a pastor on. They'll bring their religious leader on to help tell them or to help make you believe they telling the truth. And it ain't good. It ain't good, I'm telling you. Fixing this charter is not good for us as a people of color. And I'm talking about the district three, the district that I've been known to vote in, the district that I've been known to go to consolidated government and talk about the four corners getting fixed. You know, that's in District 3, making sure that we have lighting in our community that's not all haywire, making sure that the streets don't have too many potholes, trying to get roads in our community resurfaced so it don't be tearing up our cars and things like this here. Making sure the University Carter, you understand me, when people come to visit us, it looked like we live here. You're not coming into a culture shock. You know? Oh, university, that's not in our district, but it come through our district. You know, we travel down it. If we could get that done, we could come within the community, under community development. When I go to these meetings, I go to these meetings looking out for our community, the community that we live in. And I'm talking about here in Lafayette. Anybody else gonna watch this? Try to do the same thing in your community. Try to bring it up. You know, go to council meeting. Look up different things. We all got smartphones. We all got computer. We all be on social media checking out what's going on. Check out what's going on in your community. What you would like to see better in your community. You know, they're talking about a Walmart closing here in Lafayette, Louisiana. Walmart closed. But you're going to have somebody come on the news and on TV talking about some development that's coming behind Walmart and making them close. You got 193 families coming there plus. Why would Walmart close for that? That's not the reason why Walmart closed. Walmart closed because of I-49 connector. Carter is coming that way within the next 2 or 3 years or less. And when they're going to start busting up the roads and detouring traffic and things like this here, Walmart couldn't take the hit. That's why Walmart closed. They already was in a financial crisis being there. And with the I-49 connector coming, guess what? They would have been in a bigger crisis. And if anybody have any sense to answer that question, that's why Walmart closed. You know, that was one of the reasons that helped Walmart make the decision to close. But you're going to hear, oh, it's behind some low-income housing was coming behind Walmart. That's affordable housing is coming behind where Walmart was. Affordable housing. It's not going to be Section 8 housing. You know? And guess what? A councilman decided to make arrangement to get that there to help build up our community. And it seemed like they're using us to hate on him on what he's doing for his district, because the other guy's not doing nothing for his district. Or are you going to tell you, you know, J.C. Penney and the shopping mall over there, that's all his. No, 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 no. you know. That's none of that, you know. Get in the heart of your district. Get in the heart of your district and see what's going on, you know. 12 years and something just beginning to happen, you know. Come on now. Stop beating up on us, you know. Stop beating up on us like, you know, it's all of that. Christianity and equal right. You call yourself a Christian, you got equal rights. Big time equal rights, you know. Your God have a voice in you, just like you got a voice in voting. Everybody that's gonna come to you and tell you this is the person to vote for, ask them how much money they get to push that candidate. You know, ask them how much money they got to push, fix the charter. Because if it wasn't no money involved, they wouldn't have got involved in fixing the charter. When you can hear somebody say, I never agreed with Joey Durrell, you understand me, on nothing. And then all of a sudden, you know, he agreed with Joey Durrell on fixing the charter. That ain't good. I wish I had a phone in the front of me that y'all could call in and tell me, you know, what y'all think about fixing the charter. But before it's all over with, you know, I'm going to have that opportunity to have that phone line open to where y'all could call and tell me just what y'all think about fixing the charter, you know. Like I said, DOJ, Department of Justice, don't let nobody violate your voting rights. And they're trying to do that all the time. Gerrymandering, purging us off the voting list. Try to stop you from voting, you know. But we have to keep up with that. Looking out false teaching. Always be careful of what you hear. When you keep on talking, trying to make lies sound like the truth, you're still lying. Nothing in this is for me other than the district that we live in, I live in. Why are you so adamant about what this district look like? Why are you so adamant in trying to destroy what's already here, what's already there? Why? Answer me that question. Why are you so interested in tearing it up? I'm interested in keeping it together, because it was very well put together. It was our district. It was the district that a lot of people was accustomed to. It's a district that we're used to voting in. It's a district that we voted a councilman in, that we wanted in because we felt he was qualified to be our councilman. This is why I'm speaking up against fixing the charter, because you tearing up a district that I'm accustomed to. You tearing up a district that you don't know nothing about. You know? You don't know nothing about District 3. And that's the district that is really being chopped up. Because you're going along with the attorneys that consolidated government paid for? I don't pay. My tax dollar go to paying him or them, even you. You know? But I don't feel that you have the rights to come in my community and destroy it. You're destroying the community of the district that I live in, that we live in. I'm not in this by myself now. I always say I live, you know. But it's about we. We some Frenchmen. We know what we mean. We are all in this together. So please understand some of what I'm trying to say. You know, I had a six week retreat. And in that retreat, you know, I learned not to be ashamed of the gospel. Okay? I learned that. I also learned that God have not given us the spirit of fear, but of love and power of a sound mind. If we have a sound mind and have enough faith as small as a mustard seed, we could move mountain. But we living in the good old USA. We was born in the USA. We was raised in the USA. I should say the US of A. We was raised in the US of A, you know? We do not have to be ashamed of God's work. We don't have to be ashamed, you know? We need to be strong in grace. You know, and because anyone gonna sound good, gonna do the facking and the macking and all that other old bull crap, you know? You got a brand bank, you know? Ain't about nothing. You keep on talking. You trying to make us sound like we got to hear you. I hear you. But guess what? What you're saying ain't the truth, you know? Like I said, I got to keep on bringing it. Fixing the charter is breaking the charter. It's breaking us up as a district. It's breaking us up as a culture of people, people of color. And I hope, I just hope, somewhere along the line, we understand and make them fix this to where we go to a revote. You know? We got to take it to a revote. Them going and, you know, say, well, this is how we're going to do it, and this is why we're going to do it. No, you put it together. Tell us this is what it's going to be, and let us take it to the next level. And the next level, just like you brought it to us for us to vote on it, bring it back to us when you get it right, and let us vote on the right thing. Because what you doing, because of you going with the council, you know, y'all did some crooked things at first, and you're going to do some crooked thing again. So now, put it out there right. And if you put it out there right, you understand me, and let us read it, let us fix it to where we know what we're talking about, or we know what y'all talking about, and don't rush us through like y'all did the last time, you know, and try to put it on the back burner, put it in with the primary election, not on a runoff election, knowing that people don't come out as much in the runoff election as they do in the primary. Put it in the primary election. You know, that's all you got to do. Put it in the primary election, let us go and vote on, then we'll know where we're going from there. Stop trying to disrupt us. Okay? How much time I got?
About 10 minutes.
About 10 minutes, okay. 2:46. Consider what I say. And maybe the Lord give you the understanding in all things. Consider what I say. And may the good Lord give you understanding in all things. Because right now, we in a world of trouble. And I'm talking about the people of color in the city of Lafayette. Everybody have a right to run for office. Matter of fact, let me put it to you like this here. I might even be considered running for office because some of us don't have dogs in the fight. Some of us don't have no understanding of what they're doing. You know, all they understand, hey, look, you do this, I got this envelope right here for you. You understand me? And when you get through, I got some more for you, you know? I need to remain in the district we voted our councilman in. I need to remain in that district, you know? And anybody that voted for your councilman in your district, you should fight to keep him in your district. Don't just let everything and anything come in your district. When a person can't take care of the district that they're supposed to be voted in, but want to come over and take care of somebody else's district, something is wrong with that picture. You know, what's the problem? Next time we're going to talk, you know, I'm going to tell y'all the problem. I'm going to tell y'all the problem. Okay? And anybody know me, ask me and I'll tell you the problem. I don't want to push it out the way right now. You know? No. I don't want to do that. You know? But hey, it is what it is. It is what it is. And you know, like I said, we have to stay loyal to the district or to the people that voted us in office. I run for office, I guarantee you. I'll be loyal, but I doubt if they would ever let me get in office. They might say I'm too controversial. You know? They might say I'm looking out too much for the culture of my people. They might say, well, you look out too much for colored people. No. I want to look out for all the people. Not some of the people. All of the people, all, regardless of race, religion, creed, or color, that's all the people. But you're segregated by district. District first, all second. District first, all second, you know? Oh, well, let's put it like this here. All first and district second, you know? Either way, make it balanced. The people that voted you in should have the biggest voice. Because you're in office, that don't make you bigger than no one else. Only you're sitting in a seat that the people put you in. I don't care who you are, from the president to the governor to the council to all our little surroundings. You can't just look out for one side. You got to look out for all sides. Because in a box, you got four squares, four corners. So you got to make sure all four sides is done. If you take care of all the people will take care of you. You take some of the people, you got to go try to convince the rest of the people that you're going to do what you said you was going to do and never did. That ain't good. That ain't good at all. You know? So this is where I can't say we fall short of the glory of God, because that wouldn't be right, you know? Approve and disapprove workers. A man of God and the Word of God. Let's learn how to live with our Lord Jesus Christ. We have it. We have it. You know? On my retreat, I learned so much, you know? I learned so much in my retreat. 6 weeks of retreat. Galatians to 2 Timothy, you know? Galatians to 2 Timothy, it was all good. You can't enslave a Bible reading people. You can't enslave a Bible reading people. You know? Because the Bible, is the principle of the groundwork of human freedom. Let me read that again. It is impossible to mentally or socially enslave a Bible-reading people. The principle of the Bible are the groundwork for human freedom. The principle of it is like basic instruction before leaving Earth. It's only the basic. It's only the basic. You know? We're going to get our final instruction when we get where we're going. You know? I want good instruction when I get where I'm going. I don't want nothing bad. You know, because it could happen. It could happen. Freedom. Freedom. The coming of the law. You know, let's make sure that we're on top of it. We could do this. We could do this. But we have to quit worrying about negative things. We got to stand fast. Pray and ask. Ask for you to receive. And if anyone don't want to obey the law of God, shame on them. You know? If you talking and you keep on talking, trying to make a lie sound like the truth, straight up lies, sounding like the truth. Shame on you. You could research. Research this. Research this. Not we. What I'm talking about here, this is a we thing, you know? We need to look out for false teachings. We need to be careful of the lies that sound like the truth. All this is of we. We Christians and equal rights. We have rights as Christians. Christianity, you know, religion, all that. Whatever you're into, you know. Each and every one of us have equal rights. And we all have a right to vote. We all have a right to vote, but if we don't make it for us to register to vote and get out and vote and try to make sure your fellow man, your fellow neighbor, your fellow relative, your kids, your grandkids is not registered to vote, shame on us. In other words, we not doing our civil duty. Don't let our civil right movement slip away from us. Women have civil rights also, equal rights. We have civil rights, equal rights, voting rights. Sometimes I say my voter's registration card is better than my driver's license, you know? Because I could always prove that I'm a registered voter. I carry my cards with me, along with my ID, which is my driver's license, along with my Social Security card. I carry those credentials with me at all time. When you register to vote, when they gonna send you your card, don't set it on the dresser or in your drawer. Put it in your wallet, put it in your possession. So if anybody come at you and say, are you a registered voter? Yes, I am. And you have proof. It's just like the police will walk up to you and asking you for your driver's license, which is a form of ID. You don't even have to be driving. But it's a form of ID to prove who you are. And if you got your voter's registration card with you, you could prove you're a registered voter. When you go to the poll and they say, my name is not on the list, well, I don't know why. I have a voter's registration card with me here. And they're going to let you vote because you got that voter's registration card with you or sign an affidavit. You know? I was talking to a young lady today, and we're going to have a conversation about that, you know? We don't understand how important it is for us to be registered to vote. Registered to vote, and let's get out and vote. You know the old saying go, it's best to be registered and able to vote than to not be registered and want to vote. Or we need your vote. please people. Register to vote. Please people, this is an important election coming up this year. Your vote, your voice. I guarantee you that. It's nothing to be afraid of. If you want to go vote and you think you have some fear, take somebody in there with you that'll help you. Take somebody in there with you that can help you, show you what to do. So guess what? The next time, you'll know what to do. And if you don't understand it, then take them in there with you again. You know? You have that right to take someone with you to show you what to do. Okay? Believe me. And I'm asking you again, over and over again. But look, we're going to take this Community Matters up on next time. You know, thank you for allowing me in your home, in your ears, in your eyes. You know, I also want to thank my producer, Brother Jay Vallo, for offering me the opportunity to be in the front of his camera to bring the word with wisdom, knowledge, and intelligence of the grace of God to you guys home. I thank you for all that you have done to bring me into your home.